cosmic strings are fictitious one-dimensional space-time anomalies that could have developed after the division of a singular force into the forces of gravity, the strong nuclear force, the weak nuclear force, and electromagnetism in the earliest Big Bang universe. When this phase change took place, it did not happen all at once throughout the cosmos, but rather separately in numerous different regions of space-time, and topological defects or wrinkles emerged at the boundaries of these regions. These segments passed into a unique condition that was distinct from the regular state of space-time. These were the cosmic strings. Thomas Kibble, a British physicist, made the first prediction about the existence of cosmic strings in 1976, and Yakov Zeldovich, a Soviet scientist, developed their theory by 1981. The cosmic strings have a diameter that is much smaller than the size of atomic nuclei, approximately 10 to the minus 29 centimeters, a length of at least tens of parsecs, and a linear density of 10 to the 22 grams per centimeter. This means that only 1 kilometer of the string contains 1/6 of the mass of the Earth, indicating an extremely high density. It follows from the theory that cosmic strings were either closed or limitless when they first appeared soon after the Big Bang. The strings break, bend, and overlap. The string's broken ends are promptly joined to create closed portions. The threads themselves, as well as each of their individual pieces, move through the cosmos at a pace that is very close to the speed of light. A cosmic string cannot be seen, but like any very massive object, it creates a gravitational lens that forces light from sources behind it to curve around it. According to recent study, these odd objects may be responsible for the magnetic fields that generate in their aftermath. Scientists suggest that these magnetic fields would then permeate the whole cosmos, explaining the magnetization of galaxies and clusters. A magnetic field surrounds almost every large object in the cosmos. Smaller objects like planets and stars have dynamos inside of them that cause weak magnetic fields to fold over on themselves, creating their own magnetic fields. On a broader scale, astronomers have seen magnetic fields inside protoplanetary disks, supernova remnants, and nebulas. In those circumstances, complex charged particle fluxes may produce weak fields. Galaxies and clusters of galaxies are some of the biggest celestial bodies, and they all have magnetic fields. Despite being normally relatively feeble, they can be enormous and can sometimes extend for millions of light years. The origin of the magnetic fields in galaxies and clusters is a mystery to astronomers. You require collective motion of charged particles in order to create a magnetic field. But before to the emergence of the first stars and galaxies, the universe was electrically neutral in its early phases of evolution. Since a neutral gas is unable to produce magnetic fields on its own, the cosmos had to produce a magnetic field in some way. In a recent study, scientists put up cosmic strings as the potential origin of the universe's initial magnetic field. According to the theory, cosmic strings would cause rippling effects in spacetime as they moved. The temperature and density of tiny pockets in a plasma may fluctuate if a cosmic string passed through it due to spacetime ripples. These variations would cause electric charges to move, and they might develop into the first magnetic field. The residual plasma might compress and cool to form stars, galaxies, and clusters once the cosmic strings had departed the region. That initial field may have been boosted into the strengths that astronomers currently observe as the plasma condensed. This idea is intriguing, but it has a serious flaw. We don't yet know whether cosmic strings exist. Although no results have been found in any searches to date, cosmic strings seem to be a universal prediction of all models of the early universe. The Nanograph team of scientists published a dataset for 12.5 years of pulsar observation in 2020. This collection contains abnormalities that can be taken as evidence for the existence of cosmic strings. The authors, however, addressed that issue and mentioned a probable cosmic string observation signature. Long after the cosmic string has vanished, those same wakes that produce magnetic fields and plasmas are still present. Gravitational waves are the last form in which the wakes are carried to Earth. The next generation of gravitational wave detectors might be able to observe the traces of the cosmic string spacetime wakes if there were enough of them in the early universe. There are instances of a cosmic string being used as a plot-forming component in a science fiction novels. A practical attempt to employ a cosmic string to achieve a speed faster than the speed of light is mentioned in one of the episodes. Maybe the day arrives when a dream comes true.